Hello, thank you for taking the time to investigate the Academy and Advanced Academic Programs offered by Virginia Beach City Public Schools. This video will walk you through completing the application for the 23-24 school year that is necessary to be considered for admission to one of these eight unique programs during the 2024-2025 school year. The eight programs that this application is used for are Kempsville's Entrepreneurship and Business Academy, Tallwood's Global Studies and World Languages Academy, the Governor's STEM Academy at Lansdowne High School, the Health Sciences Academy at Bayside High School, the Legal Studies Academy at First Colonial High School, Princess Anne's International Baccalaureate Program, Ocean Lakes with the Math Science Academy, and the Visual and Performing Arts Academy at Salem High School. In addition to the wealth of information you will find about each program, the application for all eight of these programs is located on our school division's website. Yes, you heard that right. You can complete this application once and apply to any or all of the VBCPS Academy and Advanced Academic Programs that you saw displayed on the last screen. Once you have navigated to vbschools.com, from the main menu, please select Academics. From there, you will further select Academies and Advanced Academic Programs. You will see several links along the left side menu, specifically the application process and information nights. In the body of this page, there is a link for each of the Academy programs. Clicking on the application process link will navigate to information where you can further see the link to the application, the process for applying if you are not currently a VBCPS student, and a timeline of the application process. If you click on the information nights link, you can learn more about the dates of individual opportunities to visit each program. Please note that this year the application runs from October 13, 2023 to January 8, 2024. The application closes promptly at midnight on January 8th and will not be available otherwise. Once you open the application link, you will arrive here. VBCPS students will log in with their student ID number and password just as you do on your Chromebooks. There are a few bits of helpful information on this screen, so make sure you read it carefully. Non-VBCPS students are also logging in here, but only after emailing Brittany Williams in our Teaching and Learning Department to gain access to a Google form you must complete in order to set up your user ID and password. Please remember that this process takes time, as several parties are at work to establish and activate these logins. Non-VBCPS students should plan for this time, and it is suggested that they request a login prior to the winter holidays and certainly no later than January 2nd, 2023. After logging in, regardless if you are a VBCPS student or not, the application process now looks the same. You are taken to a screen with a few more reminders and tips. It lets you know that both the student and parent will have portions to complete on the application, so make sure they are aware and available to help you complete the process. It also explains that the application can be saved, so you can complete it over time and submit it at a later date. Just remember to submit it on or before January 8, 2024. Additionally, it suggests that for the written portions, you should type your response in another app like Google Docs or Word. Then cut and paste it into the application. I will point this out again when we get to those screens. When you are ready, you will click Start Application. The first step is to select the Academy programs to which you are interested in applying. If you are still not sure, I encourage you to go back to the VB Schools website to investigate the programs through the materials provided. Applying to a program does not mean you are committed to that program, so there is no harm in applying to as many as you want and making your decision once acceptance letters have been sent. Once you make your selections on this screen, you will click Next on the far right of the screen. This screen looks quite a bit like the previous. However, this screen will only display the Academy programs that you selected on the Academy selection screen. This is your opportunity to rank the programs to which you are applying. Make sure you mark the one you are most hopeful to attend with a number 1, and mark the others in descending order of your desire to attend. Once you have selected and ranked your Academy programs, you get this summary of their requirements. Most have no additional requirements beyond this application. The International Baccalaureate program at Princess Anne High School and the Math and Science Academy at Ocean Lakes High School require an entrance exam. The Math and Science Academy and the Governor STEM Academy at Lansdowne High School additionally require students to pass Algebra 1 prior to enrolling. The Visual and Performing Arts Academy at Salem High School requires an audition to go along with this application. You will see more information regarding these requirements further in this video. For those that select the Visual and Performing Arts Academy, you will see this screen next. Applicants will need to indicate the strands that you are most interested in applying for. The information to the right of the selections appears after making the selections and informs the applicant of the audition requirements. Applicants are only able to select 2 strands, but I have displayed the audition requirements for all strands. In order to properly communicate with all those that apply, it is important for us to collect your contact information. On this screen, applicants must provide at least 1 student email, 1 parent email, and 1 phone number. There is an opportunity to provide 2 additional email addresses and 2 more phone numbers. We encourage you to provide as much contact information as possible. This is how you will be notified of acceptance to the programs for which you apply. For those that select the Visual and Performing Arts Academy, you will see this screen next. This is an opportunity to enter email addresses for arts teachers like visual arts, dance, and drama. Teachers within our school division will be provided an opportunity to complete a recommendation online. For all applications, teacher recommendations are required. This is a special screen for teachers that are not your current teachers on your academic schedules. You will hear more about that later in this video. You do not have to enter any names on this screen if you do not have any teachers for which to enter. For teachers that are not working in VBCPS, you can still request a recommendation from them. Please download the linked PDF on this screen and give it to the arts teachers you would like to have write you a recommendation. They will follow the directions from there. For any recommendations you are requesting, it is always nice to check in with your teachers, past and present, to let them know that you are applying to an academy or advanced academic program. They will receive a request to complete a recommendation for you. Not only is it courteous, but it is a great way to maintain positive relationships with your teachers. Surely they will be excited for you to embark on this new adventure. The next few screens of the application are where you may want to use a word processing app like Google Docs or Word to type your response. This screen is an opportunity to show the selection committee that will review your application what your career goals are right now and how attending the academy you're applying to might help you achieve them. Please remember that the response you type will be seen by each academy program's selection committee. Although you may want to point out how attending a specific academy program, especially your top pick, would benefit your journey to the careers that you listed, be sure to address the value of your application for the selection committees of all of the academies to which you are applying. You definitely want the selection committee to be able to see how important attending that program is to you. Remember, a word processing app will allow you to use spell check and character count features, and will give you time to think about your responses. Please note that this section has a 2,000 character limit. After pasting your response into the application, please review it for accuracy before clicking the next button. If it is beyond 2,000 characters, it will not accept the entire length of the pasted text. There is also a timeout feature in the application system. So if you take too long, the information you pasted before clicking might not save properly. It is always a good idea to save that word processing doc and go back through the application before submitting. One of the many helpful features to this application is a little encouragement. If the information you type in a field seems to be less than the volume that would be helpful for the selection committee, you will get a warning encouraging you to do better. You will then have to expand your response before moving on. Take this as an opportunity to review your response and make improvements. This screen gives you an opportunity to let the selection committee know what you are enjoying spending time doing, what is important to you, and what you are looking forward to at the programs to which you are applying. Be sure to provide details of your activities, especially if you have held a leadership role. These extracurricular activities can be at school or in the community. Whether they are sports related, involve community service, or have given you an opportunity to learn a new skill, make sure you do not leave anything out. Be sure to list the activities that you are excited for at an academy program as well. This shows the selection committee that you are already thinking about how to get involved and become an integral part of the academy community. Although the list you write in this section will likely be much longer at the end of your high school career, please take this opportunity to list the positive recognitions that you have received so far. These might be school-based, like Citizen of the Month, Honor Roll, Perfect Attendance, or even Student of the Year for a specific subject. Do not forget about your community activities. Maybe your scout troop, sports team, or church have honored you for your service or commitment to a cause, or simply pointed out a spectacular skill that you possess. Regardless, list your positive recognitions here. The next screen, or several screens if you are applying to more than one program, provides the most important opportunity to show the selection committees your unique qualities. 6 of the 8 programs require this portion. You can see all of them here. Remember, the IB and MSA require an additional admissions exam for their programs. Therefore, they do not have this portion as a requirement. The VPAA requires this portion along with the auditions. When completing this section, you are welcome to submit the same response for each of the programs to which you are applying. However, you can also write a unique response for each program. There are 4 options among the prompts, and you need to only provide one response. Read through the prompts to select the one that seems the most appealing to you and the one you feel provides the best opportunity to showcase your unique qualities. If one of the prompts provides an opportunity to share something about you that relates to the theme of the academy, that just might be the right one to pick. The selection committees will read the responses provided for their program only. This section plays a significant role in their decision-making process because it is the best opportunity to get to know you. Please know that this section has a 5,000 character limit, so use that word processing app and double-check what you paste into the field before clicking Next. For the students completing an application that are not currently VBCPS students, you will see this screen next. This screen will not appear for VBCPS students as this data is stored in our school division database and is attached to your application once you click Submit. For those that need to complete this portion, here are a few helpful hints. First, download the teacher recommendation form linked on this screen. You will need to print and make enough copies to give each of your current teachers a copy. They will then need to complete the form and return it to you. Once you have them all, you should scan them as one file for upload. You also need to request your transcripts from your middle school. If you attended multiple middle schools, this might be time-consuming, so plan accordingly. You will need a transcript that shows all coursework, attendance, and testing history throughout middle school. The last item you need to upload are your middle school report cards. Ideally, this would be the end of 6th and 7th grades and the most current for 8th grade. Once you have all of these items, transcripts, report cards, and teacher recommendations, you are ready to upload. You can scan them all and upload as one document as long as it is under 6 megabytes. You can upload each category separately as you have up to 3 documents that you can upload. Please do not upload one and then come back later to add the others. Each upload event will replace the previous with the new document. So uploading one time is best. However, you can certainly save the application and come back to this part later once you have the documents needed. But it is very important that you do not forget to do that before submitting your application. Once you have selected the items to upload, you must click the Upload button. You will then see that the documents were in fact added to your application and have a date of upload attached to them. Remember, if you only upload your transcripts and report cards, then save and come back later to add your teacher recommendations, your transcripts and report cards will be replaced with the teacher recommendations. You can upload a second time, but you will need to include the first things you uploaded in the replacement upload. The most important thing before submitting your application is to verify that the files you want and need are included in the list under Uploaded. Remember, this is not a process required for VBCPS students, as their data will be uploaded from our databases housed by the school division. The next few screens are for the parents only. Hopefully, you have prepared your parents for this portion and expressed how excited you are for this opportunity. Now hand over the mouse and take a breather. But stay close, there is more for you to complete before clicking the Submit button. On this screen, parents are asked to enter their name in the field provided. The following screens provide an opportunity for parents to highlight their students' abilities and characteristics. There are 3 screens with a total of 11 items for which to provide feedback. Parents will need to select from Almost Always, Often, Occasionally, Rare, or Never to describe these 11 items. For those applying for the IB program, the list of items for which to provide feedback are slightly different. Students applying to the IB program and another program will have 6 screens like this for parents to complete. The next screen of the parent portion of the application is where comments can be provided. This is an opportunity to describe your child's potential at finding success in a rigorous academic program. This section has a 3,000 character limit, so be sure not to use unusual characters or too many blank lines. The next 2 screens require a bit of conversation between the applicant and their parent or guardian. On this screen, you must select the method of transportation that you think you will need if accepted to the program. All students accepted to a VBCPS Academy or Advanced Academic Program are provided bus transportation unless residing in the walking zone of that school. Although this information can be amended with the registrar and academy coordinator at the school upon registration, it is important that this is accurate as possible for our planning purposes. Please note that bus stops are generated from the address on file with the school division. It is imperative that families keep the school division up to date when there are any address or contact changes. Please open the link included to learn more about the citywide programs and bus transportation. This screen is where you will read through and agree to the admissions requirements of the VBCPS Academy and Advanced Academic Programs. Please notice the scroll bar on the right side of this screen. Be sure to read through the entire Academy admission agreement before completing this screen. After reading, both the student and the parent will need to check the appropriate box to indicate that they agree to abide by the terms and conditions for participating in these programs. Please note that this step is date stamped, and students are expected to adhere to their agreement with fidelity throughout the 4 years of their high school academy experience and understand the consequences if they do not. Although this looks like it is officially the end of the application, as you can see by the Submit Application button, there are a few more screens to go. This screen provides you with an overview of the programs to which you are applying. Although all 8 appear here, it will only show the ones that you personally selected on the first screen and ranked on the second. Please note that for the International Baccalaureate Program, the Math and Science Academy, and the Visual and Performing Arts Academy, there are additional notes and links regarding the application process. It is very important that you click on the links, which will open in a new tab on your screen. Each is unique and gives you the information you need to register for your required testing or audition. By clicking Yes, Submit My Application, you will not be able to go back and make any changes to your responses. Think carefully before clicking, and maybe go back and make sure that all is complete to your liking. But by all means, do not forget to complete this crucial step by January 8, 2024. Once you officially submit your application, you are directed to this confirmation screen. Once again, you will have access to the notes and links associated with each program. At the bottom of the screen, you can click on the Application Status button to return to the home screen that you will see when logging into the application portal throughout the selection process. After starting or fully submitting an application, this is the screen that will open every time you log in. On this application status screen, you will see your current status indicated. It will say open if you have not yet submitted, and submitted if you have already done so. There will be green check marks next to the completed items or red X's next to the items you have yet to complete. You can click on the text next to the red X's to go to that portion of the application to complete it. Once you submit, you can click on the text of the portions you submitted to view them, but you will not be able to edit them after submitting. For those applying to the Visual and Performing Arts Academy, the Academy Coordinator will update this item after you have completed your audition. Remember, once your application is submitted, VBCPS teachers will receive the request to complete your recommendations if you are currently a VBCPS student. No need to worry, your school counselors and administrators are working behind the scenes to make sure that all of your data and recommendations are available for the selection committee to review. In the evening on Friday, February 23rd, 2024, emails will be sent notifying students if they are accepted, waitlisted, or denied acceptance to each program for which they applied. The emails that offer acceptance to a program will direct students to complete specific tasks to accept the offer or notify the school that they declined the offer. Do not worry, all directions necessary will be provided in the emailed letter. Now, let's recap the most important things to know. The application for current and non-VBCPS students lives online at vbschools.com under the Academics tab. The application opens for students interested in applying to one of the 8 Academy and Advanced Academic programs for the 24-25 school year on October 13, 2023. The application is due by midnight on January 8, 2024. Information about these 8 programs is available at vbschools.com, but you can also speak with your school counselor about these wonderful opportunities. Thank you and good luck.